Different things to us, and y'all probably heard Dabo tell a story about when Coach Stallings was playing golf with Ben Hogan, and he was in the golf cart with Ben Hogan, and he asked Ben Hogan, does he ever wish his opponent to have a bad shot? And Ben Hogan hit him in the chest, and he said, no, I always want my opponent at the best. So anytime you going for a championship, you want to play your best and you want to play against the best.
When you think back to where you were then, coaching Dabo at Alabama, winning a national championship there, how much do you think that's helped him and this team get to where it is now, going to play another national championship?
I think that helps, but even more so than that, Dabo had a very good high school coach in Billy Tohill. Billy Tohill had been the head coach at TCU at one time. And so he got a good background there. And then when he went to Alabama, he was there. And his first coach was Tommy Bowden. And then when I went in there, then he had two very good head coaches, and Bill Curry and Gene Stallings. And y'all always heard the stories about him being a habit note taker. And I mean, I think those things really helped him. And he was able to go back and pull some of those things out. And even since he's been a head coach, I mean, he had the opportunity to work here on the Tommy Bowden. You can see some of Coach Stallings' things in him. You see some Tommy Bowden's things in him from an organizational standpoint and all. And he's put together his own style. And that's what I like about him. I mean, he's taken some of those things, but he's put in a lot of his stuff, too.
What's it like for you personally to have coached at Alabama, you won that championship there, now you're going against him?
Well, I mean, that's coaching. That's coaching. You know, at some point in time, you know, it's going to come to an end here. You hope it will not ever happen, but the biggest thing is during my career, I've been able to navigate, you know, around the college scene. I've had opportunities to coach pro football, but that's not me. That's not what I ever wanted to do. But, you know, it's good that most of my career has been in the South, in the Southeast, and that's a good thing about it. And, you know, having the opportunity to play against Alabama, you know, here, while I was at Tennessee, played against them, Mississippi State played against them, South Carolina and all. So, you know, it's just part of the profession. Part of the profession, and at some point in time, if you're going to stay in it long enough, coach is kind of like the military. You're going to move around quite a bit, and you're going to see things like this.
How would you compare being a part of this staff here versus being part of the staffs you were at Alabama?
Well, the biggest thing is the difference in offensive philosophy. Because back then, I mean, some of the basic fundamental things, run the ball, stop and run, B-plus and giveaway, takeaway ratio with turnovers and all that still come into play. But the philosophy that Dabo has here on offense is a little bit more wide open than what we had at Alabama, because then, you know, we were more tight end, two backs, two receivers. Here we got a lot of time, four receivers on the field with one back. Every now and then we'll complement a tight end in there and make people defend the whole field. You know, where there, you know, it's kind of like playing in a phone booth a lot of times. That's what I associated with. And things have changed. And when we came back here in 2008, some people questioned it. They questioned it because they said that wasn't the Clemson way. But it's still, you know, with Clemson being able to, a good running football team at that time, back when I was here before and during Coach Ford's era, still has not stopped us from running the football. Because I think Wayne Goldman has had a very good year this year, and he's proven that you can run the football out of wide sets.
You've been around this program since the beginning when Dabo took over in 2008. How has he grown as a coach, and then how has this program changed over the last few years?
He's grown a lot. You know, I see a lot of his confidence in him, knowing what he wants to do. And, you know, it's kind of like, you know, when you're raising a kid, it's just like my son. You know, the older he got, I start backing away a little bit, watching him and watching him grow. And that's been kind of the same way with Dabo. When I came over here in 2008, there were some things that he did through trial and error. You know, now he's had a lot of the trial, and it's not much error. And a lot of people questioned some things that he did then, you know, and all, and didn't know if it would work. But we all see today that it does work.
His you've been around really good coach Gene Stallings, Philip Pullman, especially. What makes Dabo different than these guys?
Well, you know, our style back then when I came along and all those guys you just mentioned, you know, you were the head coach and everybody else was kind of here. You know, Dabo was with us. But then when he sits at the end of the table, you know he's the head coach. And, you know, he can separate that pretty quick. And he walks the halls. He's around our players. He's in the locker room. He's around them out on the practice field. Back then, you had a lot of coaches coaching under Tyler. That connection with the players was not there. And I think that's what makes him so dynamic. He's with the players. He's around them. They respect him. But he can let his hair down with him, too.
Listen, a lot of coaches would say, don't give away so much of yourself to the player. You know, reveal so much. Why does it work for you?
I think it is. Today has changed. You know, these kids today, they're a lot more informed. They know a lot more of what's going on today. And because they carry this around, and they stay in touch, and he's that way too, and that's the way you got to recruit. You know, back when I came along, you know, you was writing notes, writing letters, and you was on the phone with them. But today, with all the recruiting rules and everything that we have, you got to be more involved in social media and those kind of things. Even though he does not allow it during the season, but at some point in time, you know, he has to do it through our system. Here. So he's more engaged in that, and some people took the philosophy that, you know, we gonna recruit. The guy want to come here, he comes. If you don't, forget it. But Dabo works at it. Our staff works at it, and I think that's why we've seen a lot of success with us on the recruiting front.
When did you realize he was gonna be a special coach? Was it when he was a position coach for Tennessee, Mississippi State?
No, I knew when he walked in my office after he graduated. He had a very good job, and he walked in there and he told me that he wanted to coach. And I took him down to Coach Stallings' office, and the coach told him that he didn't have anything, that he would start him out in the weight room. He took it. And I knew how much he wanted it then. By turning down a job, taking a position in the weight room. And then after that, he got a chance to be a GA. And then all of a sudden, he's full-time because Coach Stallings saw what was in him. And plus, we needed some young blood on the staff at that time. But after he got on the coaching staff, and I saw the drive that he had, I knew he was going to be a special guy. And then even more than that, the 2 years he was out, and I know how much I was trying to help him, and a lot of other people were trying to help him get back in. He never let it go. He never let it go, and he was religious about it, that he wanted to coach and he wanted to get back into coaching.